Hello, I'm Arcade Main Machine, and this is Star Trek Online. In this video, I want to show you something, because currently on the Tribble test server, they're running some things to do with the 5-year anniversary update. And one of the things that I want to show you is the weapons fire rate, but also showed their DPS compared to what they are now. And you'll be surprised if you don't already know about this, if you've read it in the forums but don't know what it's actually going to mean. This video is hopefully going to try and help you understand that, weapons like the full auto, phaser rifles, or full auto in general, the bulk prosthetic tactical drones are going to be nerfed considerably. Their fire rate has been changed, and their sort of reload has been changed as well. So you'll see some weapons like the compression phaser rifle sped up in a way. I don't know. I would have to do a comparison between the two, which hopefully I'll try and do in this video. I'll try and do a side-by-side comparison of the full auto from Tribble and the full auto from Holodeck and so on for each weapons that I'm going to show you in this video. I have a few that I can show. The corrosive plasma full auto, that has been changed. The Omega Force anti-proton autocarbon has been changed. The TR-116B has been changed, but this one, not because it's full auto, but because it's slow fire rate in general. So that's been changed. Weapons like the phaser pulse wave haven't been changed, but I think their DPS might be. And by the way, when you're looking at stuff in your inventory, even though I'm in Deferia ground invasion and I'm fighting at level 50, while they're in your inventory, they do not change. But as you can see, that's now 123.2 DPS with 154.1 phaser damage. And then it's 168.3, 134.6. So it's in your inventory, it shows it's not natural power and DPS regarding the weapons. For the pistols, some pistols, I feel that this one has been changed. I've already tested this, and I feel that the fire rate has been changed, but I could be wrong just because of how laggy Tribble is a little bit. It's like you can press a buff and it doesn't quite activate straight away. So it could be just that regarding those. And the plasma piercing full auto beam, full auto, because it's technically a full auto, is still the same. It can fire a constant stream. As long as you're looking at the target, you can fire a constant stream of plasma at the enemy, whereas the Borg prosthetic arm used to be able to do that, whereas now for the 5-year anniversary they're changing it so that it doesn't, and I'll show you that in a moment. So if I equip the Zephyrin Cochrane shotgun and an advanced or full auto phaser, and I'll go and show you what I mean by this change. So I'm just gonna, because this is empty at the moment because it's the Tribble side of it, which nobody plays on here really. They do, people do, but so now I'll show you the fire rate in your tower. There is a longer pause in the reload. Or the... And you can tell there that it's a lot longer fire rate now. The secondary is still pretty much the same, but that first one, the three bolts going out is the same, but it's that reload, which is a lot slower. So I'll do a side by side and you'll see. Now we'll move on to the Zephyrin Cochrane shotgun, and don't know if this one's changed looking at it, but it could be. I guess you'll see in the side by side. And now I'll move on to the Borg prosthetic arm and the Jem'Hadar full auto. Now, hopefully on the left or right, whichever way I'll do this, you'll see that with the holodeck version now, you'll get a constant fire rate, whereas them changing it so it's going to be like this. Now, this is all subject to change. Whether they actually do or not is another matter. It's just they're testing you. They're testing. But for me, I don't like this. It's not as bad as the normal full autos, or like the Jem'Hadar. That fire rate has really been slowed down, and it's also the DPS which affect them quite a bit. Now, because I'm at level 50, 119 DPS, that's taking it into it's lower. It's showing lower than a phaser in my inventory. So that tells me what does a type 3 phaser go down to? 112. So it's only just a little bit higher than a type 3 phaser. It's like, come on, they need to be a little bit higher, because there's more fire right there. And I know people complained that they were, too overpowered. So again, I'll show you the two of the four auto rifles. This one is a corrosive plasma, and you can tell that reload is way too long. So now we move on to the Omega anti-proton full auto. It's too long in the reload. But it's still got 132 DPS, which could be good. But it only goes up to 144. But that, fair enough, I could upgrade that to Mark 14 Epic and see what I can get it up to. But I'm only probably going to get it up to about 160, 170 DPS. Whereas compared to now with a on holodeck, I know that it's 232 point something. That DPS just way too low. I don't mean to kind of be a bit whiny, but the people who complained, they shouldn't have really. They shouldn't be complaining about a gun. And guns like the pulse wave haven't changed, but I think their DPS might have. So I will have to check this. I know that it should definitely be a bit higher than that on holodeck. So yeah, 168.3 with 134. So this is what to expect if they go along with it. Which to me, I think they should just leave them alone, and just ignore everybody who complained. You see that second fire rate. I don't know whether it's the triple test server doing that, but it seems like it's been adjusted. And this is the plasma piercing, which still has a constant stream, for all you guys who didn't know that. Which, to me, would make it the best gun to upgrade. You won't get that higher damage out of it, because I've upgraded this to Mark 14, and it does 56 plasma damage, but being as it does a constant fire stream, fire power, it's actually worth using. And I've used it quite a bit on missions, and it does well. So what I think I'll do now is leave it there. If you've got any comments and any thoughts on whether they should leave it as it is, or if they should change it, but only drop it, because the way that I can see it with most of the weapons, these are you're losing around 100 to 110 DPS, and about 10 sort of damage. So what they need to do is maybe say drop it down so you're only losing 40, 50, or maybe even 55 DPS. Then that would be you know, tolerable, would be better. At least the weapons would still be useful. Because I know I can understand what people are saying is that, being as they're so high DPS, you don't need to use any of the other rifles or weapons that you have. But it also comes down to preference and what you like to use. So yeah, that's, so you can see the Jem'Hadar drops down to 130 DPS, Borg Mark 12 drops down to 142, Zephyr Cochran Shotgun 187, Phaser Full Auto is 183, which I know is 269 on holodeck, or thereabouts. Compression phase rifle probably won't have changed much. Omega Force Anti-Proton Autocarbine, that's definitely changed a lot. Corrosive Full Auto, Plasma Wave Assault, and the Sniper Rifle. So you'll get a bit more insight into what they're doing, and hopefully go on the forums and tell them not to reduce them so much, because that would be helpful. And that's it. I hope you found the video helpful, and I'll post another one soon.